Nothing to see here, just a plain old MacBook Pro starting up. It's astonishing, really, not the fact that the latest macOS Sequoia works on this 2009 Mac, but the fact they managed to make it even slower than the previous version, Sonoma. I mean, of course it's a SATA SSD, which is much slower than an NVMe SSD, or whatever kind of built-in storage Apple Silicon Macs have, but other modern operating systems, like Windows 11 or modern Linux distributions, don't take this long to start up. Obviously such a new OS isn't designed for this hardware. But hey, it works. As usual, I can't complain. It's all thanks to the OpenCore legacy patch. And now the fan started running at full speed because Mac's fan control started up. This computer was cold. It hasn't been turned on in a few days. But just starting it up now made the CPU go up to 80 degrees Celsius. So now that program puts those fans at work to make it cool down a bit. Anyway, here's the newest version. At least I think so. Are we connected to the network? If there was a newer version, it would warn about it. I just set up the installation flash drive, which by the way, you cannot use a 16GB one anymore. It doesn't fit. So I had to use a larger USB drive, then booted from the special OpenCore bootloader, installed the OS with a USB mouse and keyboard, then connected via Ethernet to install the post-installed root patches to get the rest of the internal hardware working. And there it is. Let's turn off night shift for a moment. There it is, macOS Sequoia 15.0. The real deal. The only changes I've noticed is this new iPhone mirroring app, which isn't available in the European Union. But even if it was, I don't have a compatible iPhone for this, and this computer doesn't have compatible Bluetooth hardware. This is the new Sequoia wallpaper, some redwood trees, though these two new wallpapers, Sequoia and Macintosh, do not work. I think they need to be rendered in real time, and it must need metal graphics acceleration. But other wallpapers work, especially the static ones like this one. I've been trying the Arc web browser, just to see what all the hype is about. It's okay, but it has your bookmarks and tabs on the side instead of the top. And of course it's based on Chromium, so it might be worth checking out, but I'd still argue that the best monopoly alternative is Firefox. Oh, and also it made me accept some new iCloud terms of service. Not relevant if you don't use an Apple ID, or Apple account should I say. Everything else is basically the same as Sonoma, so no need to repeat myself. Here's MacBook Pro, picked up from the laptop microphone, but let's start it back up and you'll be able to hear the fan again. It's less hot than the diode itself, so maybe instead of 4080 we can do 4070. And just watch the CPU diode temperature. 80 degrees Celsius is already quite hot, so we need to be careful. It would also be a good idea to take apart the computer and reapply new thermal paste, but I've been too lazy to do that for now. So let's shut it down. And now let's take a look at this non-Apple computer. Sometimes the Windows Boot Manager takes over, so I have to go to this menu and select this EFI file to load grub, from which I can load OpenCore. As a reminder, this is an HP Compaq Pro 6300 desktop computer, currently on a triple boot with Windows 10, Ubuntu 22.04, and just recently, macOS Sequoia. It starts up much more quickly. despite this computer still being a bit old for modern macOS standards. It's from 2012. Although the same applies in that it's a bit slower than the previous version. The menu bar still hasn't loaded yet. There it is. And over here, OpenCore Legacy Patch is used only for the graphics card. Post-install root patch for this Nvidia I have installed. But for the OpenCore bootloader itself, the regular version is used, not Legacy. It's pretty fast, but it has no Metal graphics acceleration. One problem I noticed, let's see if we can reproduce it. Let's take a screenshot of the system settings window. The colors are all weird. Not sure why. It could be caused by the web drivers. I installed this app called Better Display to adjust the settings. I saw this option to change the color depth from 8 bits per sample to 10 bits. 10 bits is more glitchy, and you can see, for example, the highlight for general has these weird colored corners. And if we take a screenshot of that, its colors are still glitched. So I don't know if it's because I messed with something or just a Sequoia glitch. So let's go back to 8 bits. Screenshot colors are glitchy on the real Mac too. Check this. Yeah. Shameful, honestly. So yeah, always discovering a little issue. And here's a screen recording test from the HP Compaq. Hopefully this is less laggy. For the microphone, I'm using my phone with a megaphone app connected to the computer's line in jack. So hopefully it sounds good enough. And of course, these two new wallpapers don't work here either. But this new dynamic one does work pretty smoothly here. So let's watch it break slowly. There it is. And shut this down as well. Thank you for watching.